Good morning, students. I hope you enjoyed the last two sessions. In the past two sessions, we dealt with seed formation, maturation, germination, and problems associated with seed germination. In this session, we shall learn about seed senescence, its role in seed storage, and implication in agriculture. In simple sense, senescence means aging. Aging is a series of deteriorative processes that naturally terminate the functional life of an organ or organism. Senescence is an irreversible process. All the living organisms age, just like we humans who are born as a child, then we become youth, followed by middle age, and finally we become old and die. When we are as a child, we are susceptible to diseases, but when we are as a youth, we are energetic and not prone to disease. But as we become middle aged, we become susceptible to diseases, and upon old age, we become prone to diseases that slowly kill us. Similarly, seed being a viable organism, they also undergo senescence process. Senescence thus is a phase of aging. The major characteristics of seed senescence is that metabolic processes are mostly catabolic and eventually become irreversible and terminate in death. During seed formation, it is mostly anabolic, or formation of stored food and storing it, but during senescence, it is mostly catabolic and stored food is consumed for respiration. As the stored food is used, gradually the stored food becomes less and less and the seed lose vigor. Senescence is not confined only to a whole plant. It may be limited to a particular plant organ such as leaf and flowers or cells or cell organelles. Senescence is closely associated with the phenomenon of aging, and aging thus leads to senescence. So, when do seeds start aging? Seeds start aging once they reach physiological maturity. At physiological maturity, seeds have stopped accumulating food and embryo is morphologically complete. So, beyond physiological maturity, seeds just lose moisture and are amenable for harvest or storage on mother plant or shed to ground. Hence, beyond physiological maturity, seed starts to store and hence they start to age. If the seeds are dried to low moisture contents of 10 to 12%, then the respiration will be slow and seed senescence will be slow. If the moisture content is high, as in times of rainfall during maturity, then seed moisture will be very high and respiration will be high and seed senescence will thus be faster. Causes for seed senescence. There are two primary causes for seed senescence. The first one is genetic and the second cause is environmental. Genetic causes are intrinsic or inborn. Based on intrinsic properties which determine the degree of seed senescence, seeds can be classified into microbiotic, mesobiotic, and macrobiotic. Microbiotic seeds age very fast due to poor seed structure that offers little protection against environment. Such seeds have high metabolic rate because high humidity outside leads to increased seed respiration and faster senescence. Soyabean is a microbiotic seed. In this seed, the thin seed coat is easily damaged and the large cotyledons easily absorb moisture and seeds respire fast. Such seeds store for less than 1 year and are to be carefully handled to prevent mechanical damage while processing, handling, and the seeds are to be stored in cool, dry environment to delay senescence. Mesobiotic seeds, on the other hand, can be safely stored for 2 to 3 years. These seeds possess thick seed coat that are not easily damaged and can be dried to low moisture content to reduce respiration and thereby seed senescence. Cereals and millets are mostly mesobiotic, so are castor, groundnut seeds stored in pots, mustard seeds, sunflower seeds, etc. They can be safely stored in bags and the atmosphere controlled to reduce humidity. Macrobiotic seeds are those that can be safely stored for more than 5 years. These seeds possess exceptionally hard seed coat that is impermeable to moisture. Hence, upon drying, the embryos are protected by hard seed coat that prevents entry of moisture, thus respiration is reduced and thereby senescence is slow. Apart from intrinsic causes for seed senescence, eccentric causes like environment, pests, diseases also decide seed senescence. If the seeds are exposed to high humidity or rain during development or harvest, then they age faster. Influence of pests like borers, bugs increase seed senescence because injury by pest increases seed metabolism, causing seeds to age fast. Diseases like downy mildew, sooty mold, fusarium, aspergillus affect seed organs and lead to faster senescence. Post-harvest operations like threshing, processing, transport can cause mechanical injury to seed coat. Injured seed coats become permeable to moisture, leading to faster metabolism and seed senescence. Improper storage environment that increases seed moisture can also age seed faster. Apart from the microbiotic, mesobiotic, and macrobiotic seeds we have already seen, a special category of seeds called recalcitrant seeds have higher senescence rate because they do not undergo maturation drying. These seeds are shed from mother plant with high moisture and thus have high metabolic rate and age faster. Seeds like coconut, cocoa, jackfruit, and jamun belong to such category. Similarly, tubers, bulbs, rhizome, sugarcane sets, bulbils also have high senescence because they are propagules that require high moisture for being alive. Knowing the causes for seed senescence, how do we go about protecting them? Since we cannot do much about the genetic causes, we try to breed soybean with thick seed coats and increase the phenolic content or tannin content in seed coat to prevent insect infestation. We can manipulate the eccentric causes, planning seed production in such a way so that seeds mature in cool, dry weather and avoid weathering damage. Protecting seed by spraying fungicides, pesticides prior to harvest will prevent field carryover of pests and diseases. Preventing seed damage during processing, handling, and transport, and reducing the seed moisture content to safe levels will reduce seed injury. Maintaining low humidity during storage will reduce seed senescence. Students, till now we saw what is seed senescence, what are the three types of seeds, namely microbiotic seed, mesobiotic seed, and macrobiotic seed, and what are the causes for seed aging. especially the intrinsic causes and the eccentric causes, and we also saw how we can manipulate the eccentric causes and reduce seed senescence. The next topic we are going to learn about is seed quality characteristics. Farmers should be provided with only quality seeds, because use of quality seeds alone can provide 20% higher yield, which we have seen in the earlier sessions. At present, only 24% of the Indian farmers use quality seeds. Rest of the farmers use only seed stored as grain. Thus, farmers suffer gaps in field due to poor germination, uneven maturity, and reduced yield. Seed certification ensures that only quality seeds are certified and provided to farmers. So, what is seed quality? Seed quality is characterized by high genetic and physical purity that is accompanied with physiological soundness and robust health. We shall see the quality characters one by one. The first one is physical quality. Cleanliness is godliness, is an old proverb. Similarly, a seed that is clean, has desired moisture content and free from other seeds, debris, inert matter, diseased seed and insect damaged seed is said to be of high physical quality. The seed with physical quality should have uniform size, weight and color. It must be shiny and appealing to the buyer. The color must be normal and not bleached. It should be devoid of shriveled, diseased, mottled, mold infected, discolored, damaged and empty seeds. It must also be free from stones, debris, dust, leaf, twigs, stems, flowers, fruit bits, which are called inert matter. The seed should be easily identifiable as a species of specific category and variety. They must also be free from other crop seeds, other distinct variety seeds, designated weed seeds and noxious weed seed. Lack of this quality character will indirectly influence the field establishment and planting value of seed. Physical quality ensures that seeds are physically sound, robust, appealing, evenly shaped, removed of thorns and other appendages, possesses desired moisture content for proper storage, free from debris and other inert matter. This quality character is ensured in seed lots by proper cleaning and grading of seed after collection. The next most important character is genetic purity. The farmer is dependent on genetic purity because it is essential for higher yield and price. Genetic purity means the seed is true to its varietal specifications. If genetic quality is poor, there will be plants of varied duration, varied maturity, uneven size of vegetable shape, which will reduce the value of produce and cause loss to farmer. Certification ensures that seeds sold in the market have minimum 98% genetic purity. The third most important quality is the physiological quality. The physiological characteristics of a seed comprise of seed germination and seed vigor. Farmer is more bothered about this quality than any other seed quality. The farmer always desires that whatever seed he sows must germinate. So, if seeds germinate properly, then he is satisfied. If not, he will be angry and fight with the seed distributor. The liveliness of seed is known as viability, the extent of liveness for production of good seedling, or the ability of seed to produce seedling with normal root and shoot under favorable condition is called germinability. Seed certification ensures that seeds are tested in seed testing lab prior to distribution. Only seeds that possess minimum seed germination alone are allowed to be sold in the market. Seed vigor is another concept that is also very important, because even if the seed possesses higher germination, the conditions at the farm level may not be the same. If the soil at the farm is hard or not well prepared, then seeds will fail to emerge. So, seeds must possess high vigor or stamina so that they can germinate in any conditions. Seed vigor can be described as the energy or stamina of the seed in emerging faster and in producing sturdy seedling. It is also the sum total of seed attributes that enables regeneration under any given conditions. Seed vigor determines the level of performance of seed or seed lot during germination and seedling emergence. This quality determines the field establishment of crop under varied environmental condition. The fourth most important quality is seed health. Seed health is determined by the absence of insect infestation and fungal infection within or on seed surface. In today's world, diseases and pests spread faster because seeds from one country are brought by seed companies and sown in India. Thus, pests and diseases from that country can spread it into India. The farmer is unprepared for such events. Hence, seed certification monitors seed health in the field and in storage and during import or export to prevent spread of diseases. In order to ensure spread of disease and pests, seed certification ensures that all seeds are sold only after seed treatment with protectants. To summarize, we can say that quality seeds should have high genetic purity, high pure seed percentage, that is physical purity, high germinability, which can range from 85% to 90% depending on the crop, high vigor, higher field establishment, free from pests and diseases, good shape, size, color according to the specification of variety, high longevity or shelf life, optimum moisture content of 6% to 8% for long term storage and 10% to 13% for short term storage, and finally, high market value. So, what is the significance of quality seeds? Quality seeds will provide the various benefits, like it ensures genetic and physical purity of crops, gives desired plant population, ensures uniform growth and maturity, seedling produced will be vigorous, fast growing and resist pests and diseases, will possess capacity to withstand adverse conditions, will promote development of root system that will be more efficient in aiding absorption of nutrients and efficiently and result in higher yield, will respond well to added fertilizer and other inputs, will prevent spread of diseases, weeds and pests, ensure higher returns at premium price. Good quality seeds of improved varieties, as you know, will always ensure higher yield by at least 10% to 20%. Dear students, in this session, we learnt about seed senescence and its causes. We also saw how seed senescence is linked to both intrinsic and eccentric causes, and how seeds are classified as microbiotic, mesobiotic and macrobiotic. A special class of seeds known as recalcitrant seeds also exist, which do not dry and shed with high moisture content, thus making them senescent faster. We learnt about measures to reduce seed senescence from the field itself until they are processed, handled, transport and stored. In the second part, we dealt with seed quality and came to understand about the four major seed quality characters like genetic, physical, physiological and seed health, and how seed certification ensures the seed quality before being sold in the market. Always remember, we cannot do away with seed senescence, but we can slow down the aging process by management practices. We can boldly say that all seeds are not quality seeds, and only certified seeds alone are quality seeds.